Before your purchasing tools will work for you need to define those min and max levels. Okay, when is your inventory too high and when is it too low, right? But before you define those min and max levels, you have to first classify your parts. Okay, so what I mean is there's really three different types of parts. Everyone has about three different types of parts. They have the type of part you want to always keep in stock and never run out of. Give yourself a little cushion. It'd be really bad if you ever run out of this. Your customers will be pissed off if you ever run out of it. That's your A-class part. The other type of part is your B-class part, and that is you want to keep it in stock, but it's okay if you run out of it every once in a while. Your customers aren't going to be upset. Sure, the lead time may be a little bit longer, but it's a rare part and they're not demanding it and their expectations of a quick lead time are not high. Those are your B class parts. You don't sell as many as the A. And then you have your C class parts. Those are the parts that you don't want to keep in stock. You just don't sell them often enough. And you could also call them specialty parts. The customer does not expect a quick turnaround. They're just happy that you have them or that you can get them, right? That's a C-class part. It's the kind of part that the customer is just happy that you can get them and they don't expect you to keep them in stock, okay? So let's write this down. I'm gonna go to my Google Drive and go to my shared folder, Brando Common. Got all kinds of goodies in here. If you'd like access to this folder, let me know. I'm going to create a new Google Doc called ABC Classification. Now, if you Google or YouTube ABC Classification, you're going to see a lot of different videos on here that show you how to calculate. This video, I'm not going to show you how to calculate. We're just going to talk about and define the concepts. So concept one, A-class part is a part to never run out of. Always keep in stock. Calculate reorder point beginning with safety stock or minimum stock. In other words, with your A-class part, you don't ever want the part to get below the minimum. Let's say you have a vendor that usually has a lead time of 2 weeks, but there was one time that he was 3 weeks late. Totally freaked you out, put you in panic mode, and the hurt was there. So the lead time is 2 weeks, but then since that one time he was 2 to 3 weeks late, your safety stock will be that 2 to 3 weeks because you cannot afford to ever be out of this type of part. So calculating the reorder point for this type of part would be reorder point equals lead time in days plus safety stock or minimum stock in days times average sale per day. Okay, that's how you calculate a reorder point for your A-class parts. Now your B-class part is a part you want to keep in stock, but it's okay if you run out of it sometimes. So 80% of your sales or 85% of your sales come from A-class parts. Maybe about 10 to 15 to 20% of your sales come from B-class parts. So it's okay if you run out of them every once in a while. You don't need safety stock. You don't need minimum stock. So to calculate the reorder point for a B-class part is its reorder point equals lead time in days times average sale per day. Notice the difference. No safety stock, no minimum stock in the calculation. So then a C-class part is a part you shouldn't invest in stocking. Don't invest storage space. Don't invest money in keeping a C-type part. In other words, buy it when you need it. Buy it in reaction of a sale. Don't stock up on it in anticipation of a sale. So how do you calculate the reorder point for a C-class part? Sorry, that was a trick question. There should be no reorder point for a C-class part. Reorder point for a C-class part should be blank or zero. Now you may be wondering, is it even worth to have the C-type parts on the inventory list in the software? Yes, absolutely. You're not gonna hurt anything keeping your part list full in your inventory software. Just don't pack your warehouse with the goods of the C-type parts, but go ahead and put all the parts in there. So 80% of your income from 20% of your parts. You could also say a high percentage of your usage if you're in manufacturing, right? So it's not an exact science. B-class parts is your 15% of your income from 75% of parts. And then your C-class parts, 5% of income from 5%. And honestly, this may change. You know, this may be 50% of your parts are your B-class parts. 30% of your parts are your C-class parts. Or it could be 30% or 50% of your parts on your part list, okay? But the goal is for 0% of your parts in stock to be C, and most of your parts in stock to be A. So don't keep in stock, but leave on the part list in the software. I say 80% of income, 15% of income, 5% of income. This is where the calculations can vary, because what if you're a manufacturer? And it's not about income, it's about usage. It's about that important part that if you don't have it, then it shuts down the whole assembly line, right? So because of the importance of the part, it may be classified as an A-class part. That's one reason why this ABC classification is not an exact science. Could be 80% of usage, 15% of usage, 5% of usage. So before you can leverage the software to give you good recommendations on what to purchase, reorder points should be carefully calculated. And before you carefully calculate them, you should classify your parts and decide which parts should have reorder points and how those reorder points should be calculated. I'm Lance with Brando Consulting. Hopefully this video was helpful. Like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Comment below if you have any questions.